because we all need a bit of comfort, and you can do that by getting a hug. And in these crazy times, we need them more than ever. One native New Yorker has become famous for her cuddles. Her name is Loubie, and let's welcome her and her dad, Caesar, to the show. Hello.
Hello, how are you?
What a cool-looking dog. Hi, it's great to see you, Caesar. Good
Thank
to see you,
for
you
having
too,
us.
Loubie. Oh,
of
so cute. Hey, how did you discover that Loubie loves hugging?
She was about 3 years old when she started hugging. She's now 10 years, just to give you an idea. So it's been already a few years that she started hugging. We were walking and she kept shaking, asking me to shake over and over. And at one point, I held her paw strongly, and then she sat up and crossed the paw over, one paw over the other paw.
Oh.
And then every walk it became that, or she's hiding now. And every walk it became that, like every 2 blocks, she will start doing that. And I think it was about 2 months after that, instead of doing the crossing the paw, she just went and wrapped my legs around my knees, which is, you know, a very unusual hug. And I think that's what, you know, got her to become famous, you know.
Oh, that's beautiful. That's the way I hug, yeah. We can see all the pictures here. People obviously love it. How do people on the street react to it?
So, you know, everyone gets very touched by, you know, just the scene, like when she's hugging me or when she's hugging someone else, I can hear from behind that everyone saying, oh, you know, and like what a cute puppy. And people were already floating the internet with pictures of her. And I was like, I took a long time to create her social media. I was actually not planning to do that. So our story, in a way, became popular, but in a very organic way. It was not a push, you know, with marketing or anything behind. It was just very organic.
Well, you can barely walk around the block now without stopping for a hug. It must take you ages. Loubie's become Manhattan's most famous dog. Can you tell us how she helped out with the marriage proposal?
Yeah, it was in November 2017. At the beginning of the month, that I got I don't remember if it was Instagram or Facebook, I got a message from an Australian guy. His name is Dylan. And he sent me a story telling me that he wanted to propose to his fiance in Central Park, because he was there. The last time that he was in Central Park, he was sitting on a small hill overlooking at the ice skating rink. And in his head, he was saying to himself, the day that I'm going to, you know, be in love and ready to propose to my fiance, I'm going to bring her here. So he sent me that message telling me his story. And he was like, you know, she loves Goldens, I love Goldens, and we know about Louboutina. Would it be possible, you know, that you guys help me to propose? And I was like, we're 100%, you know. It was just so touching, the story, that I was like, yes, you know, we'll be with you. And it was very, very sweet when we surprised his fiance. Now they are together still, of course. You know, I think they got married, Golden Retriever as well. And it was just very sweet that we walk into, and she was like, oh, Golden Retriever. And then she was like, wait, this is Louboutina, right? And then she was like freaking out, and that's when he, Dylan, you know, went got on his knees and proposed to her. So it was just very special, very sweet to be part of it, to witness that. So
it is beautiful.
Friends from Australia.
And she found the camera there for sure, Loubie did. It's such a nice feeling too. It puts a smile on people's face. And what I love about this is Loubie isn't just about hugging random strangers. Tell us about the work that she does in the local hospital.
Yeah, so I work in a hospital here in New York City. I manage the language department, so I work with interpreters and translators. And for years, she's been coming to the hospital you know, to provide some emotional support. And now during COVID, especially, she was very key for, you know, all the stress that was going on through all the, you know, medical staff, you know, doctors, nurses on the unit since, you know, we got the surge at the beginning in like April. So it was very hard, and she was key. We were being extra careful, of course, you know, like Purell before touching her, Purell after touching her. But she was able to bring, you know, smiles to the hospital. And we always do. We always, you know, go to different events. We get calls from different departments. So it's always, and she has a huge following, actually, at work, which is very funny. If they know about me, it's because of her. And I am the employee there.
Oh. Well, she is just heaven. If you need a dose of happy, you can check out Loubie's Instagram page, at Loubutina. NYC. Caesar, thanks so much for joining us, and that beautiful dog of yours, Loubutina. So nice to see her. And thank you for sharing her with the world.
Thank you so much.
Oh. That's great, isn't it?